Hi everyone. So yesterday I had posted a video about being brave, and everything that I said in that video I still hold true, but I'll tell you, today I was kind of gripped with a little bit of fear because my son Christian was diagnosed with Lynch syndrome. So it turns out that he has that same genetic mutation that I have, which caused me to have cancer. So the only good thing about this is that now we can be proactive in helping him to, you know, keep up with what he needs to make sure that he doesn't get the cancer. But that's not a guarantee. We know that with Lynch syndrome, it puts you at major risk for colon cancer, among other things. But anyways, we're working on that, and we're going to be talking with doctors and meeting with them to figure out what to do and get my other kids tested as well. But you know, something that I have been thinking about, and it's really, really hurt, just got my heart, was this whole idea of suffering. And how, when I, back in 2003, a lot of people who know me know that my family went through a really hard time of suffering. Nothing compared to what we went through recently, but it was pretty difficult. My husband went through a surgical procedure that was really bad, and long story short, he was a quadriplegic for about 9 months, and he had to learn to walk again, and it was pretty bad, but we came through that. And I remembered talking to God at that time and getting so close to God. I was reading my Bible every day for hours on end, and it was during that time that my faith really grew immensely. And up until 2016, before I got diagnosed with cancer, I had pretty much read my Bible every single day. I was leading Bible studies. I was doing everything I could to show people the power of God and how much He loves them, because I believe that with all my heart, and I still do. And then I got cancer, and that shook my faith. Now, my faith got shook in 2003 when my husband got really sick, because at that time we really believed, you know, that God was going to take care of us. So when I got cancer and I was devastated, I remember just sitting there talking to God, saying to myself, I can't believe you let this happen. I really felt betrayed. I really felt like his daughter, and that as his child, he should protect me from such things. And I know that's crazy thinking, and I know that that's foolishness, because so many people go through a lot of suffering. So many people who have pleaded and begged for mercy from God have not had that mercy. And then there are other people who do get it. And then not too long after that, 7 weeks after I got diagnosed with cancer, my husband got diagnosed with cancer. And then in the middle of that, my daughter came home and told us she was a heroin addict. And then my other daughter got pregnant, and my son lost his job, and there was just a barrage of things happening one after another. It was nonstop. And here I am now, it's 2019, and September I lost my husband, and I'm trying not to get emotional, but I miss him, you know. And so when I lost him, it was just so hard, because he was my best friend. So I sit here and I think to myself, you know, why so much suffering? When we hear the news, when we see the pain in the world, and we see so many people going through so much difficulty, how is it possible to tell people when they're in that much pain that God loves them? Because for many people, that's like a slap in the face. I mean, when you say to somebody who is dying, or who just lost a child, or who's suffering with cancer, or they're watching their children stuck in addiction, and you tell them, hey, God loves you, I mean, that's kind of like, what? You know, you just want to tell them to go freaking shut up, you know, or they look crazy. But I believe He does. And I think that we're seeing things in a wrong way. I think that, and I hope I can articulate this the right way, but we live in a fallen world. Many of us have heard that many times. And the Bible tells us that Satan is the god of this age. You can look at any translation you want to, and it will pretty much tell you that he's in charge of this world right now. Now, some of you may automatically come back and say, well, if God is in control and God is more powerful, then why does he allow this to happen? And that's because of free will. He would not break free will. Now, if I, as a mother, were God, you better believe that I would take my magic wand and I would go and make sure that all these certain things would come into place so that my daughter wouldn't have had any addiction problems, my husband wouldn't have gotten cancer, I wouldn't have gotten cancer. But I also would have to ensure that in me doing that, I may interfere with other people's lives. So for example, if I didn't want my daughter to meet a particular person, I would have to prevent that from happening, which may alter that person's life. I hope you get where I'm going with this. Basically, God is not going to interfere with free will. He will not. He will not break free will. So now imagine the job that God has of trying to show people in a very broken world that even though they're going to get hit with sickness and disease, because he told us in the Bible that we would not be free from problems. In fact, he said, in this world, you will have troubles, but take heart because he overcame the world. And what he means by that is that when Jesus died on that cross, he paid for our sins. He took over that. The devil doesn't have the rights to our souls anymore. Jesus does. Before that, we just kind of sat in our graves. There's other things too theological to get into right now, but basically what Jesus did was he broke the power of sin and death in our lives so that when we die, we go to God. And so now imagine the job that God has of trying to show people who blame him for everything that he loves them. Now, I had a hard time because if you know anything about me and the pain that I've endured for these past 3 years, it has been at times so unbearable. There are times that I've looked at God and I said, I am begging you, please stop this pain. But he didn't. There are times that he didn't. I begged him to let my husband live, but he didn't. I think about friends that I know who begged God to let their child live, but he didn't. And I look at moms and dads out there who are watching their children die from addiction, begging God, but he didn't save them. And then there are times that miracles happen. But when we ask God to use us, when we say, God, I want to be used by you, which is a prayer that I prayed many years ago. What if the way that he answered me isn't going to look so pretty all the time? What if God says, I'm willing to use you, but it may not look as good as you want it to be? You know, we're all for sharing in the glory, but what about the suffering? So I had made a decision a few days ago. I felt the power of God in my life very strongly a few days ago. And I felt like I was entering a different chapter of my life. I knew that my son had genetic testing done, and I had prayed that God would not let him have Lynch syndrome, but it came back today that he did, and I was really upset by that, and I know he was too. My heart broke for him, but it doesn't mean that that gene will express itself, but whatever. You know what? No matter what, I choose to serve God, and the reason is because there is no other explanation in this world for how we got here that makes any sense to me. But what does make sense is that when I see God transform someone's life that was not transformable, that, you know, the unlovable or the people who are just total messed up, and then all of a sudden God comes in and they turn their lives around. Or when I see how God provided for me every step of the way, I mean, even today I've been struggling, but even today a good friend came and helped. When I think about how what the devil throws at us, you know, God comes back with something else to help us. He said he would go with us in this life. He would provide for us. He would be with us. He would not leave us alone. He didn't say we wouldn't have troubles. We will. But it's like having a constant friend who is your father, who loves you, who stays with you every step of the way in your journey. But I'm telling you now, when you ask God to use you, when you say, God, I want to use you, it's not always going to be as a worship leader. It's not always going to be as a pastor in a big church. Sometimes it might be great, whatever it is, but would you be willing to go if God said, hey, I'm going to send you to this horrible place and you might get executed there, but 3,000 people are going to follow me because of you, and then you're going to enter at glory? Would you be willing to do that? One of my posts that I wrote in my Eclectic Counselor page was similar to that. I had said, imagine if we were souls that were being sent to the earth, and before we were sent to the earth, we were before God, and we said to God, you know, God comes to us and he says, hey, guess what? You know, I'm sending you guys down on a mission to earth, and you're all going to get to have different jobs you're going to be doing, and it's going to be awesome. And because of you going down there and talking to all these people, more people are going to end up knowing me and knowing that I love them. And I kind of picture Shrek, and I picture Donkey jumping up and down saying, pick me, pick me, pick me. And so God says to one of them, you know, hey, you're going to get to go in Hillsong. You're going to go work for Bethel, or you're going to go into this worship ministry, or you're going to be the big pastor at this church, etc. And so all those people run and run and run, and they're like, yay, and they want to go. And then he says to another person, you're going to get down, and, you know, your life is going to be hard. You're going to get cancer. Things are going to be difficult for you. You know, you might have this happen and that happen, but I promise you, I'll be with you every step of the way. I will help you, and your life is going to become a testimony to many, many people, because they're going to understand through their own suffering that I am here, that I am real, that I do love you. And I can imagine that those people didn't want to go, you know, because that's why we don't know what happens to us in the future. I mean, if God told me that I was going to go through what I've been through. And trust me, you just have the little bit of the frosting on the cake of the stuff that I've been through in my life. I think I've been through so much so that I could actually understand people. But if I were to, you know, have an opportunity to sign up for that, hell no, I would not have signed up for this. But now that I've gone through what I've gone through, and I'm afraid to speak it because I'm afraid that the devil is listening, you know what I mean? But now that I've gone through what I've gone through, you know, I had to come to a decision a few days ago to say, no matter what, it is well with my soul. I know that you are good, God. And I know that you love me. And even though sometimes these things in life really suck, and sometimes the pain can be so great, God is there. He is real. He does love you. He does care. And no matter what you go through, hang on. Because you win in the end. The good thing is we know the end of our story. We know that no matter what happens, this is just a glimpse. This pain, this suffering, this is just a small, small inkling of what is going to happen when we meet Jesus in glory one day. One day it's all going to be good. It's going to be beautiful. This whole world will be remade. All new, we will live right here the way it was meant to be with God as our King. To some of you, that may sound insane. The Bible tells us that the wisdom of God is foolishness to those who are perishing. Because if you don't know him, you won't understand all that. But get to know him because he's good, he's kind, he's gentle, and he cares for you. I felt compelled to share that with you all today. And I just want to thank everybody too who's been by my side every step of the way. My family, my friends. You know, I have people from all walks of life who I love. And people who have different belief systems that I love so very much who have loved me back. Even through my own beliefs. And I just want you to know that I love you. And today, whatever you're going through, because I know I'm going through my own stuff, but whatever you're going through, God is with you. You are loved. Hang in there.